Baba boom! Welcome to another story of the end of the world. Brr, bada boom! Countdown to Magageddon. And you think the comet that wiped out the dinosaurs was quite something? Well, it was peanuts, really. Some hundreds of millions of years earlier, a volcano did a much more thorough killing. The bad thing is, the next super volcano is about to go boom. Think of every species of plant animal you can think of. Now imagine that 9 out of them are no longer here. Not much left, right? Still, that's exactly what happened 248 million years ago when the world was struck by the biggest natural disaster known in history. During the Permian-Triassic extinction, 90 to 95% of all species died out. No one really knows what sparked off the event, but according to the leading theory, the killer didn't come from outer space, but from below, from underneath what is now Siberia. There's a disproportional big volcano popped up. It spewed out enough lava and gas to blow up the planet's climate and reset evolution. Now, there's volcanoes, and then there's volcanoes. In 1783, the Lackey volcano in Iceland erupted, belching up almost 5 cubic kilometers of super hot lava. 9,000 people perished right there on the spot. 80% of all livestock was killed, and a quarter of Iceland's population was killed in the aftermath. The dust blocking the sun pushed down temperatures several degrees on the entire northern hemisphere. Now that's what a geologist would call a small volcano. A pimple popping open, really. How different it was 65 million years earlier when a volcano made a mess of what is now India. For several centuries in a row, a volcano pumped up something like 40,000 cubic centimeters of molten rock. The Icelandic eruption, 100,000 times over. Some scientists still blame the volcano and not the comet for the extinction of the dinos. Obviously, supervolcanoes can be, well, a little problematic. Ordinarily, volcanoes just pinch a tunnel in the Earth's crust, but a supervolcano is a completely different thing. A supervolcano is what happens when pressure builds up in an underground lake of magma. A supervolcano is much like a high-pressure balloon full of lava exploding when it erupts. And it really erupts. So, well, you say, we just run away, right? If only it was that easy. An even bigger problem is that the lava itself is the ash. 64,000 years ago, a supervolcano made a mess of what is now the U.S. Of the current 50 states, 21 of them were covered with a layer of ash. At some places, was over 20 meters thick. Well, who cares, you may think. We just dusted it away. But it isn't that simple. Volcanic ash is not like the ash you find at the barbecue. It's made up of tiny pieces of rock, and it falls on your roof, and your house can collapse under its weight. If it gets into contact with cars or airplanes, they will break down and crash. Even worse, if you inhale it, the ash will mix with the liquids in your lungs and form a cement-like substance, and you literally drown in concrete. So you take a boat to another continent, right? Wrong. Apart from lava, volcanoes also spew out a deadly brew of toxic chemicals. There are sulfurous gases that all turn into the rainfall, into a blistering downpour of pure sulfuric acid for years to come. There are all kinds of chlorine-bearing compounds that will break down enough of the ozone layer to turn the sun into a real killer. Then there's the carbon dioxide, the greenhouse gas that not only nibbles away at the ozone layer, but also causes long-term global warming. But that's not the last, nor the least. There's soot. A super eruption will darken the sun and gradually push the Earth into a nuclear winter. For many years, even centuries, we will have to survive in total darkness and cold. Okay, we may be smart enough to escape from the lava and the ash, dodge the acid rains, survive the nuclear winter, and protect ourselves against the killer solar radiation afterwards. Plants and animals definitely will not. We'll find ourselves in an increasingly empty world as one species after another just goes extinct. In the end, even the toughest survivalist would probably starve to death. In fact, 74,000 years ago, humanity almost did. In those days, a supervolcano erupted in Toba, Sumatra. Sumatra. Quite a lot of scientists believe this is what pushed humanity to the brink of extinction. It is a well-established fact that in those days, humanity suddenly was reduced to a slim total of some tens of thousands. All right, but that was a long time ago, you might argue. Well, here's some bad news. Geologists also agree that another supervolcano will definitely show up sometime, somewhere in the future. It'll be a bit inconvenient. No one knows when it'll happen or when. Where it will happen or when. But that's not even the worst part. If you still want to have a good night's sleep tonight, you better stop watching this now. For actually, the next Magmageddon is due to arrive any day now. At this very moment, a well-known supervolcano broods its ugly plans right under the beautiful Yellowstone Park. On average, the Yellowstone supervolcano erupts once every 600,000 years. The last time it erupted was 640,000 years ago. Oh, and by the way, in parts of Yellowstone Park, the ground has gone up 70 centimeters during the last century. Also, a lake has flooded with lava. A consequence of some of the innocent magma flowing from one place to another, no one really knows. Seems like the stage is set, though, for a very nasty surprise.